Hello. Easter was a month ago, but I still have a few eggs that I collected during the Easter egg hunt and wearing a rabbit ears hairpin. Now, there aren't a lot of movies about Easter or dedicated to it, even though it's one of the most celebrated and most commercialized holidays alongside Halloween and Christmas, and the mascot, the Easter Bunny, only gets his time on the big screen when all the other holiday mascots have come together, like in the Santa Claus sequels and Rise of the Guardians. Maybe there is a reason as to why there's little Easter cinematic representation, like maybe it's just the timing of it all is not usually the strongest when it comes to box office revenue or something like that, you know? It's more of a financial reason than it is a creative reason. However, there was one movie that decided to go and take that risk and take the Easter Bunny and put him in the mainstream in the hopes to turn Easter into a true cinematic event, and that was simply titled Hop. Easter is a great holiday to discuss, so let's hop to it.
Bunny hop hop hop. Bunny hop hop hop. Bunny hop hop hop. Bunny hop hop hop. Bunny hop, hop, hop. Bunny hop, bunny hop, bunny hop.
The story. Time to hop into the story. Beneath Easter Island, in a giant factory that manufactures the world's Easter candy, the popular rabbit is preparing to pass the mantle to his son, E.B. But E.B. has no interest in the job and would rather be a drummer. He runs away to Los Angeles, where an unemployed slacker named Fred O'Hare accidentally runs into him. Feigning injury, E.B. tricks Fred into giving him shelter, but an oversized chick is playing a coup d'etat back on Easter Island. I'll deliver my opinion on this movie. This is the first movie I know of that's entirely about the Easter Bunny. Behind the scenes. From the creators of Despicable Me and the director of Alvin and the Chipmunks comes a delivery from on the set. In the Universal logo at the beginning of the movie, the Earth is shaped like an egg. EB was designed by Peter DeSeve, who created a lot of the Ice Age characters. Throughout the movie, you can see the Stax Records logo imprinted on EB's t-shirt. This is Illumination Entertainment's only live-action slash animated hybrid film. The characters. Let's hop with the characters. E.B. is the Easter Bunny's son who is next in line to become the new Easter Bunny. However, he prefers to be a drummer. When he runs away to Los Angeles to pursue his dream, he gets taken in by Fred. He is voiced by Russell Brand, who also voiced Dr. Nefario from the first two Despicable Me movies, and Creek the Troll from Trolls. Then there's Fred O'Hare, who is an unemployed slacker. He gets urged by his parents when he's still living with them, much to their annoyance, to get a job and a new home of his own. At the end of the film, he becomes co-Easter Bunny alongside E.B. And there's Carlos the Chick, who served as the Easter Bunny's second-in-command until he attempted to overthrow him. He would do anything to rule Easter. Plus, his fake-kind persona happened to get the bunny's attention since he was also the second-in-command. Furthermore, he keeps his plans as a secret very well. E.B. is 24 years old during the film's main events. If the movie takes place in 2011, he was probably born in 1987. Fred's last name is O'Hare. Hare is another word for a rabbit. This is the first film to have a CGI rabbit protagonist. The Easter Eagle will now deliver comments about this Easter film. Hop brings product placement to new levels with 92 different companies earning spots in the film, including Holiday Inn, Krispy Kreme, Lindt, Kraft Foods, The Hershey Company, Build-A-Bear Workshop, Kodak, Hallmark, HMV, and Burger King. This is Elizabeth Perkins' second live-action film to have animals running a secret business. Her first was Cats and Dogs from Warner Brothers, released 10 years prior, which also had as part of the live-action cast. James Corden, Daniel Radcliffe, Matt Lucas, Eddie Izzard, and David Tennant were all considered for the role of E.B. 7 years later, James would later go on to voice a rabbit in fellow live-action slash CGI hybrid film Peter Rabbit by Columbia Pictures slash Sony Animation. Will Ferrell, John Cusack, Dave Thomas, and Andy Dick were considered for the role of Fred O'Hare. Ricky Gervais, Jim Broadbent, Michael Caine, and Ralph Fiennes were all considered for the role of Mr. Bunny. Christopher Lloyd and John Goodman were all considered for the role of Carlos. Steve Buscemi, Bill Hader, and John Leguizamo were all considered for the role of Phil. With almost a year between the theatrical release and home media release, Hop has one of the longest times for a home media release for an animated film. During the film's release, an E.B. stuffed toy complete with drumsticks was available from Build-A-Bear. The legend of the Easter Bunny grew out of German Christian traditions but was popularized by the Brothers Grimm. This is the third film in 2011 to cross the $100 million mark after Rango and Just Go With It. This is the second movie starring Russell Brand in which the main character walks sadly around Hollywood while Every Rose Has Its Thorn plays, the other being Rock of Ages from 2012. The second live-action-slash-animated hybrid film to feature Tim Hill and Christopher Lennertz together after Alvin and the Chipmunks from 2007. Russell Brand, who provides the voice of E.B., also plays a theater attendant who summons and talks with E.B. for the talent show. This is the only Illumination Entertainment film to not have a sequel, prequel, or spin-off until The Lorax and The Grinch. In 2011, DoodleJump launched a Hop-themed game app for the iPhone. I hope you all enjoyed this year's Easter like I did. I better put this hairband away and wait until next Easter to wear it again. But you know, there are lots more movies and shows to go over with you, so be sure to join me on our next review. Until then, this is your pal, JD Eagle, saying goodbye.
Bunny, turn around. Bunny, turn around. Bunny, turn around. Bunny, turn around.